Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 14.5 Beta 4 has been out for a few days. I've been using it primarily on my iPhone 12 Pro Max as my main phone that I use every day. I also have it on the iPhone 11, as well as the 12.9-inch iPad Pro from 2020, which I use all the time when I'm not using my computer to edit videos, for example. And so I want to talk about my overall experience, some bugs that this has that I've been having. Some things are good, some are not, and also talk about your experience based off the YouTube community poll, where there's tens of thousands of votes, as well as hundreds of comments. So I want to talk about all of that, but first, the HomePod and the iMac Pro are no longer listed on the Apple Store. So if you go to the Apple Store, whether that be in the app on your phone, apple.com, iMac Pro is gone. It's no longer there, and neither is HomePod. Now, the iMac Pro will probably be replaced with an M1X or an Apple Silicon-based iMac very soon, as well as maybe a new HomePod, but there's been no information about that. So I really like the HomePod, but it's three times the cost of a HomePod mini, so it makes sense that it didn't sell very well. I would love to see a new version, though, that's less expensive since it has a lot more bass. Now, the other thing is, there's a new feature that, if you didn't see my video from a couple days ago about more new features that I thought was pretty nice, is if you have low power mode on, for example, and you lock your phone and you have a MagSafe compatible phone, attach MagSafe to charge it, you have a new animation that's yellow. It just matches low power mode. I did see someone say this was in beta 2, but the MagSafe animation has been broken for a little while. So it's possible that it was, but for most people it wasn't working. Now, as far as the overall experience, well, the performance for me has been good, and I've had no app crashes when going into an app, maybe like music, for example, going into music, closing it. It hasn't sort of stuttered or been slow at all for me. Everything is nice and fast. All the animations are smooth, and I've really had no issues whatsoever when it comes to scrolling through things or doing any of that sort of movement-based or motion-based things. The touch responsiveness is good when it's working, but I have had quite a few issues, and the first thing is touch responsiveness. Like I said, it's good when it's working, but sometimes in certain apps, whether that be usually third-party apps, but when I'm in apps, sometimes I just can't do anything, whether it be Twitter or even Telegram or something like that. I'll touch and it doesn't do anything. Sometimes I can scroll and it will work, but the actual touch doesn't work. It's really odd how it goes back and forth, where sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, and you'll see it's working just fine right now. If I go to Arcade, for example, I can tap on one of these, scroll through it, and it's working fine, but sometimes touch just doesn't work. I've had some issues with music, with the app just crashing, so I'll find some new music, tap on the music to play it, and it just crashes. And you'll see it sort of reloaded the album art there for a second. So it's had some really odd bugs in it. And HomePod Mini, while the proximity using sort of handoff or airdropping it to your HomePod Mini, for example, handoff does not seem to work. Sometimes you saw at the beginning of the video, it came down. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. And in my home app, my HomePods have disappeared. So they used to be right here. This is one of two HomePods that I have in a stereo pair for my office, and it's not working. So they just disappeared. Maybe they'll come back with a future update, or maybe I'll have to re-add them. But what I was trying to do is update the HomePod, and then the button for them just went away. I can still play music, hand it off. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. So it's very hit or miss, and there's definitely still some issues with it. And it's noted in Apple's notes that you can't hand off sometimes. So I know that's broken, they know about it, but and not being able to see it in the home app is a little bit of a pain since I can't see it or update it anymore. So I may have to reset the HomePods to get them to work. Now, another thing that I've found that's been a big pain for me is AirPods. So I use my AirPods Pro regularly. If I'm going to bed sometimes, maybe I'll pop them in my ears to listen to music for a bit. And while they connect, and you'll see here, they usually connect. It may take a moment. Sometimes they connect, but then they just don't work. You'll see it didn't pop up on my phone, but it popped up on these other phones. And for some reason, it doesn't seem to recognize. I'll actually have to repair the whole thing. I'll have to delete it from Bluetooth, repair. There it goes. It popped up. But oftentimes, I'll have to actually repair them to this device. So if I go to Bluetooth quickly here, tap on AirPods Pro, it says they're connected. We'll try and connect again. It says they're connected, but they don't show in the volume slider. If I play music from them, they don't work. I'll have to pair these again. This is true of not only AirPods Pro, but also AirPods Max. I've been having issues with iOS 14.5 Beta 4 with that, sort of getting them to pair. So it's been a huge pain with that. And many of you have said you've had a lot of Bluetooth issues as well, but I'll talk about that in just a moment. The other thing I see that I haven't mentioned yet is spaces that are blank showing up. So whether that be in settings, it just be at the top. We've seen that before, or maybe in music, for example, scrolling, there'll just be a blank space that shows up. Then in different applications, whether it be Control Center, it'll be a blank space. It will close the gap. There's some odd bugs going on as far as that goes. And so, like I said before, based off the YouTube community poll, the comments that everyone mentioned there, many people are having similar issues with Bluetooth and Wi-Fi connectivity. Some said that it's fixed, some said that it's not, but it seems to be a continued issue where people are just having odd issues with Bluetooth. So that could be with your AirPods. It could be with whatever you are normally using for your Bluetooth headphones. They're not working properly for everyone, and it's a huge pain. Also, a lot of people are mentioning issues with watchOS. If you're on the latest beta, watchOS 7.4 beta 4, some people are saying ECG isn't working. Some people aren't seeing their health data transfer over to their phone. And most people are just having connectivity issues between their phone and their watch. So there's something to do with Bluetooth still going on. iCloud messages or iCloud and iMessage aren't syncing properly sometimes for some people. And also green tint seems to still be an issue, although more people are seeing it fixed and less people are actually mentioning it as a problem. So when you boot up and see that flashing logo, that's gone, but people are not seeing green tint there. They might see it throughout, maybe when it's dark on a different display. So you'll see there as well. RAM management is pretty good most of the time, but right there, it just seems to keep reloading things from time to time and having more and more crashes. I've had to reboot this twice and it still didn't fix the connectivity with AirPods either. Other people are saying that they'll see lag and flickering and freezing as well. So you'll see random freezing. I've seen freezing throughout, and it's just odd that this particular beta, being that it's beta 4, seems to have more issues for me anyway than previous betas. I've heard from some of you that say it's much better. So it really depends on who you are, maybe what apps you're using, for example. So like I said, performance overall has been great, and that includes older phones as well. The iPhone 11 is not that old, but if you have a 6S Plus, for example, don't expect any huge changes between iOS 14.4, 14.4.1, or this one, for example. So expect it to be nice and fast. Occasionally, because it's a beta, you may have some issues, but again, make sure you report those in feedback, like I've said many times before. So as long as you're reporting it in feedback, Apple will work on it and eventually fix those issues. Now let's go ahead and take a look at battery. We'll go to settings, go to battery health. You can see my battery health is at 100%. And as I've mentioned many times, the battery health is measured when it reinstalls an app update or periodically throughout whenever it decides to do it. Installing an update will not decrease battery health. It's just checking the physical capability of the battery within your phone. Now, this one has been charged every single night using MagSafe on a fast charger, and it's still at 100%. Since new, I've used it every single day, except for when I was testing the 12 Pro, for example, or the Mini. Now we'll go to the last 10 days, and you can see, well, let's take a look at yesterday. I had 4 hours and 7 minutes of screen on time, 4 hours and 4 minutes of screen off time, and I used a little bit over 50% of my battery. So again, 8 hours of screen on time with this phone, that's not incredible. 8 to 10 is okay. 10 to 12 is better. It just depends on your phone, what apps you're using. And you can see here, mail, I have it on push, so I could reduce that a little bit if I wanted to, and I was on Twitter a lot. If I go to the day before, I got better battery life. 4 hours and 41 minutes of screen on time, 4 hours and 41 minutes of screen off time, and used under 50%. So it really depends on how you're using it. But I would say for me, this is much better than the previous beta. Now, as far as battery on the iPad, let's go ahead and take a look. We'll wait for it to load. And you can see it was last charged to 100% at 8:48 a.m. a couple days ago. Let's take a look at it. And 3 hours and 54 minutes of screen on time, and we're down to 28%. So I guess after 5 hours of screen on time, five and a half, We're doing a little bit better than before. I was getting 5 hours of screen on time prior to this update. I'm getting about 6 to 8 with this update. So it's definitely an improvement. But like I've said before, if it doesn't improve, I'll just wipe this and start over and see if that fixes it as soon as 14.5 is out. So on the iPad Pro, this is responding fine. I've had zero issues other than what I've mentioned on the iPhone. None of those bugs there are on here on the iPad. The iPad is very stable. No issues here. I've just had issues on the phone other than battery life on the iPad. Now with iOS 14.4.1 in general, it's okay. It hasn't gotten any worse over time so far. And about 55% still say that battery is the same or better than 14.4. So that means 45% are saying it's not great. People are still having issues, but all the issues that are in 14.4.1 are generally fixed with 14.5. Green tint is getting fixed, but some people still have issues with it in 14.5, for example. But this particular update is the only one signed right now. Apple stopped signing iOS 14.4, which means you can only downgrade to 14.4.1. And that usually means within a couple weeks or so, we'll see an update. Usually they have two released to the public, but it did take a month or so for them to do that last time. So whether or not we see 14.5 before we see an intermediate version of iOS 14.4.2 or something like that is hard to say. But based on 14.5 and its readiness, I think we're going to see a 14.5 before any other updates come out. But the overall experience of this version seems to be okay. And it's what you expect from 14.4. So it's not amazing, but it's fixed a lot of issues. There is still lag when closing apps, for example, on some people's devices. So depending on which one you have, it's going to create different situations. So it just depends what you're using and what the overall experience is for you and what apps you're using. Now, should you install iOS 14.5 beta 4? Well, if you're already on the betas, I would say yes, go ahead. If you haven't done that already, you'll have the latest bug fixes and MagSafe will work for you again, as far as the animation, and handoff will generally work for you, although it may be buggy like it is for me. However, if you're on iOS 14.4.1, for example, I would hold off if you're looking for stability. Betas were never designed to be more stable. They were designed to find issues. So normally you would install a beta and then report issues in the feedback app. Generally, betas are not considered very stable until the very end. And speaking of the very end, I think we'll see maybe another beta or a release candidate within the next couple days or so. We don't have a definite date from Apple. Many people expected an event on the 23rd, and so far we haven't seen any invites for that. So they could release some products then, maybe iOS 14.5 release candidate, but right now Apple has been very unpredictable and we're just going to have to wait and see what they're going to do. I would expect something this coming week as far as an update based on what they've done in the past. Never have I remembered in the past that they've gone to beta 4 and not had weekly updates after that. So I would definitely expect something this week, but again, that could change. We just don't know, but we're looking forward to WWDC. So in June, we can expect an event, usually in the second or third week of June, where they'll show off iOS 15, for example, and the next versions of watchOS, watchOS 8, HomePod OS 15, and all of the others to go along with it. tvOS 15, macOS 12, maybe. We're not sure what they're going to call that. So we should see all of those things revealed with a final release date, usually in September. But as far as WWDC, last year they had already released the announcement for it when it was going to take place in June. We're still waiting for that and potential products in the end of March or April. So look for those fairly soon. Now, as far as the YouTube community poll, let's go to YouTube. And at the time of this video, I usually get these ready so I can have some days off on the weekend. So you'll see it was released some time ago. It has 14,000 votes. So thanks so much for everyone that voted. And you'll see here, 19% said it's great. 4% said it's terrible. 6% said okay, but some bugs. 59% said I'm using iOS 14.4.1 or older, and 12% are using Android. And so quite a few people, most people are on the public versions, but it's okay based on what we had a couple weeks ago. If you go down to beta 3, for example, the same rate for most things. So you can expect those. I could extrapolate these out a bit to see what they're like just based off the information on the top three, but basically they're the same as people are saying with beta 3. However, the comments say something different. So let's go ahead and take a look at some of those. But before we do that, here are the things that you had to say or statistics based off battery life, how many people mentioned it, and then also crashing and lag and freezing. quite a few people had issues with lag, freezing, and it being slow, there was not one mention of the phone overheating, for example. Now, also, here are all the devices you're using as well. So these are all the devices. As you can see, the 12 Pro Max is the most popular, oftentimes the iPhone 11 as well. Now, as far as the comments, at the time of this video, there's 131 comments. Let's go ahead and sort them and take a look at some. You can see Vasco Lemos said, similar to the previous beta on my iPhone 11. Enrique Gonzalez says, call me on iPhone 12 Pro Max is doing okay, but on Apple Watch 6, my AirPods Pro keep disconnecting from the watch. It takes about 5 to 8 seconds before they connect back. Other than that, it runs smooth. I think you meant to say the beta is on that. My iPhone SE 2020 has just stopped dropping calls. I can't afford to take the risk of that. If you're on beta 3, you'll definitely need to update anyway, but if you're on a public version, then I would stay on the public version, like I said. Just Dave says, I haven't seen any issues. Apps open and close without lag or dropping frame rate. Battery is noticeably better than previous betas. Seems ready for release, running on my XS Max. Jeremy DeBose says, great on the 12 Pro Max and iPad Pro, no lag, great battery, close to 12 hours of screen on time, and it strangely seems faster than ever. Music skips occasionally on Bluetooth since beta 1 though, usually when switching apps. Everything else is serviceable, or I think running well. Samanth Parangi, hopefully I'm saying that properly, Face ID for me with iPhone 11 Pro and the latest beta for iOS 14.5 is working at almost all angles and I don't have to lean all the way, which is a great improvement. Performance is good and the only app I see issues with is YouTube. I'm on the 12 Pro Max and using iOS 14.4.1, which is found to be quite stable update, although having some freezing issues while closing apps and still with flashing Apple logo on restart. And thank you. So that issue is fixed with the betas. So when iOS 14.5 comes out, it should fix the flashing Apple logo. Integra DIY says no need to update every single time. If you're on the betas, you definitely should. And I would say for security reasons, you definitely should on public versions as well. Vasil Vadafu says we are approaching an ideal version of iOS. So far, it's been really great. It's stable. Battery life, as you are expected, great. In fact, the OS is working perfectly with hardware. I'm testing using the iPhone 11/12 Pro Max. Thulani Nala says, it's been really good on my 11 Pro, particularly on the battery where I'm getting an average of 6 to 7 hours or so screen on time. Marked improvement from the 5 hours I was getting where I was having where I am having issues is on Bluetooth. My AirPods just randomly disconnect during my running/cycling, and it's very frustrating because I keep having to pause my workouts to connect them. Anthony Lombardo said, running iOS 14.5 beta 4 on my iPhone 12, everything is great and it's smooth and stable. I just feel like the battery is draining a little quickly. Can't wait for the RC version or the final release soon. I always watch your videos, Aaron. Keep up the good work on updating us on these betas. Thank you. Julian Calderon said, not bad. I find the handoff with HomePod Mini is too sensitive and still sometimes unstable, probably due to my Wi-Fi based on PLCs to spread the signal. Battery is not bad, maybe a little bit worse than on beta 1 and 2, but not sure. No big issues, no lags, and no crashes. Arctic Fox says, iPhone 12 Pro Max running iOS 14.5 beta 4, and I still have the green tint. I noticed some flickering when watching videos on minimum brightness. The flickering was around the notch, and it flickered between solid black and a faint green, along with green tint on grays on minimum brightness. It's very noticeable in the settings app. Jury said, iPhone 12 Pro, iOS 14.5 beta 4, pretty good so far, runs very smooth and battery life is also better. Mario Goucher says, this beta has been very good on my 12 Pro. I'm so confident it's good that I've installed it on my wife's iPhone XR. Also installed the watchOS beta so she can use the unlock with watch feature. Quad Rider Honda said, running iOS 14.5 beta 4 on my 12 Pro Max, and it's been great. Love your videos, Aaron. Thank you. Vitaly A says, it's good so far, but the battery draining faster than on the official version. And then Sonido says, weak battery, the same situation on the watch. And so as you can see, the overall experience is very different depending on who's using it and what apps they're using. And so that's it for iOS 14.5 beta 4. I'm looking forward to the final version. I think we'll see an RC hopefully this week. Maybe not. We could see many more betas, but hopefully we'll see an RC. And Apple could just skip that altogether and go right to a public release, although that's very rare if they do that. But either way, we don't know what Apple's going to do. They're a little bit up in the air right now with that. And I'm sure they have a plan, but it's anything from what we normally have. So hopefully we'll have something very soon, or we'll know some more information soon. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.